hostility, not humanity. Kulbhushan Jadhav's wife asked to take off her Mangal Sutra. His 80-year-old mother's shoes declared a security threat. India fumes at the inhuman treatment meted out to the duo in Pakistan. India says Jadhav is being tortured in custody. India avenges the killing of four martyrs in the Poonch sector. They cross into Pakistani territory and gun down four Pakistani soldiers. Russian belly dancers, liquor in ambulances. That is how doctors at the Lala Lajpat Rai Hospital decide to party in Meerut, much to the country's embarrassment. And the big Virushka reception in Mumbai today promises to be a star-studded event. We'll get you live pictures as and when we get them.
मेरा तो सीधा सीधा कहना है कि गोकशी करोगे और गोकशी करोगे तो यूं ही मरोगे।
संविधान मन बदलाई इसलिए कोश कर वे नाम युरुदो नाम बंदीरो बदलाई इसलिए। ये गुलामत वाले बहुत मरो
Hello everyone, good evening. One minister threatens to shoot doctors. Another threatens to change the constitution because he doesn't like the word secular. One MLA, again from the BJP, is promising to gun down cow smugglers. And yet another BJP leader throws a love jihad fit and brings Ghaziabad to a standstill. Shake a family tree, it is said, and you will get some nuts. But in the BJP's case, it seems nuts are the flavor of the season. Can anything explain this shameful, crazy, intolerant behavior from our elected representatives? Remember, this is not the fringe. This is the mainstream. Can anyone explain the Modi government's studied silence over its hate brigade? That debate is starting in under 2 minutes. Before that, a look at who said what.
Once a part of the fringe, they are now the mainstream. The BJP hate brigade is back again. This time, it's not about any local netas who are on the loose. Now, union ministers, part of the Modi cabinet, are openly spreading hate. Meet Anant Kumar Hegde, the Minister of State for Skill Development. Hegde says that the BJP has come to power to change the constitution and will do so in the near future. Hegde also heaped abuse on secularists, saying they were like people without parentage. Now, listen in to the Minister of Home Affairs, Hansraj Ahir. Ahir, who was furious at the absence of doctors at a function in Maharashtra, issued a direct threat to the doctors. If these two shocking statements weren't enough, hear the rant of BJP's Alwar MLA, Gyandev Ahuja. Ahuja says if anyone indulges in cow smuggling and slaughter, he will be murdered. And unfortunately, it doesn't end here. A BJP neta in Ghaziabad was among over 100 fringe activists who were booked for rioting during the wedding reception of a Hindu woman with a Muslim man. They had called the marriage a case of love jihad and created ruckus for around 5 hours. In all four cases, no action has been taken by the BJP high command. No message from the top to rein in these hate mongers who are openly defying the rule of law. So the question is silence from the BJP top brass a tacit endorsement for these netas? And who will rein in the BJP hate brigade who are adamant on spreading hate and dividing the country?
A quick introduction of my guest this evening, Muna Kumar Sharma, National Secretary, Akhil Bharatiya Hindu Mahasabha. He's joining me in the studio. Vinod Sharma, Political Editor, Hindustan Times, also with me in the studio. Ejaz Ilmi, Spokesperson of the BJP, and Suleiman Mohammed Khan is Spokesperson of the Congress Party. Ejaz Ilmi, for obvious reasons, I'm coming to you. Any particular reason why the BJP is quiet about the utterances of your honourable ministers? Not a single reprimand for a Hansraj Ahir or an Anand Kumar Hegde or even a Gyandev Ahuja. Does the BJP endorse the killing of absentee doctors or cow smugglers? I mean, do you endorse that a Hindu-Muslim couple is getting married and Ghaziabad comes to a standstill and, you know, the reason given is that no one sought permission from the BJP? Do you endorse all of this?
Well, definitely not. The BJP as a political party definitely does not endorse this. The Prime Minister, not once, twice, on three occasions, has spoken very clearly that cow protection and Gauraksha maybe is a noble thing, but you cannot take law into your hands, you cannot threaten and kill people because there is a law of the land against cow smuggling and cow slaughter in 26 states of this country. If Mr. Gyandev Ahuja is saying something like this, it's obviously not something that the party endorses. The party is very, very clear, and the Prime Minister has said so enough times that there's no question of linking your own personal faith and taking violence in your own hand and indulging in violence. So the party is very, very clear. So, on the second issue of what Mr. Can I continue?
Okay, Shreya? Go ahead.
On the second issue, what Mr. Anand Kumar Hegde, the Union Minister of Skills Development at the Centre said, it's very clear that only the constitution can be amended when there's a required. There's no question of changing the constitution in any whatsoever manner. The same issue came up earlier. We are a constitutional, secular country and we should remain so. That is something that is a given.
Great.
We are not here to change the constitution because we can only have amendments as and when required, and no, there's no question of changing the constitution.
So Mr. Ilmi, the point is, I mean, what do you do to a Hansraj Ahir? Can I just quote what he said? He was furious at the absence of senior... Ek minute. So, sunne, jo log dekh rahe hain, let them get the context. He was apparently furious at the absence of senior doctors at a function he was attending in Maharashtra. He was provoked enough to say, if these people don't believe in democracy, they should join Maoists and we will shoot them. I mean, this is a minister in your government. And we are talking about Hansraj Ahir, we are talking about another minister. Have we seen even a single top leader from the BJP step out today and say what our ministers said was wrong? They should probably come out and apologize. Did we hear any such thing from the BJP today? No.
I've seen what Mr. Hansraj Ahir, the Minister of State for Home Affairs, has said so. My colloquial Marathi may not be so good, but what has been
I'll translate it for you. I'll translate it for you. Yes. What do the Naxals want?
They don't want
democracy.
It's not good enough, but I do
so
understand.
So these people, the absent doctors, don't want democracy. Then they should join Naxals. Why are you here? Then we will pump golis into you. Why are you giving goli here? I have come here and these people are on leave. What can I say? He also questioned whether it was appropriate for doctors to go on leave when a democratically elected minister was on a visit. So nothing got lost in translation. The exact translation is right here, sir.
Perfectly all right. As per protocol, the doctors should have been there.
If they are not there, you threaten to shoot them.
Shreya, will you let me speak? Shreya, will you let don't filibuster me? Let me speak.
Sir, you're the only one. You're the only one who's spoken on the panel so far. Yeah, go ahead. I'll give you 20 seconds to complete and then go to my other panelists.
Well, I'll take your 20 seconds. The minister, whatever he said, if he said. Have you thought about that? What the minister could be saying could be that we are fighting the Naxals, and if you are more interested in not attending our functions, which is happening in a left-wing extremist area of Chandrapur, then it could be in relation to that context. I mean, nobody can endorse the absenteeism or what the protocol is for doctors.
What a weak defense that is.
Minister is coming.
What a weak defense that is.
Well,
Vinod Sharma, I mean, how do you read what's going on? You know, there are nuts in every family, but as I said, the flavor for the season as far as the BJP is concerned is nuts. Here are four mainstream leaders. They are not the fringe. They are mainstream leaders. They come out to make statements that they have, and not a word from the BJP top leadership.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm surprised at what the Congress is doing, first of all, and that's a question I'm going to put to them. But your views.
No. First of all, let me give my friend Ijaz a benefit of doubt. He's defending the indefensible, but that's his party line. He has to do that as a party person. He's a reasonable man. I know him. You see, I think that the statement of the Minister of State for Home is indefensible. As a Minister of State of Home, he has to be very cautious with his words. He's, after all, a minister directly under the charge of the Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister. So I think that here was a miscalculation, and he could not perhaps formulate what he wanted to say properly. It is not acceptable coming from the Minister of State from home. But the other two statements are more interesting.
Anand Kumar Hegde, repeat offender, caught on camera beating doctors.
Each time.
Now says, I just don't like the word secular.
Each time.
And it should be dropped from the constitution. Yeah, let's change the constitution.
Yeah, each time I look at Anand Kumar Hegde, I'm very wistfully reminded of Ramakrishna Hegde, the other Hegde, the big Hegde from Karnataka, who was chief minister and who eventually also joined the NDA government, as you remember. You see, Mr. Anand Kumar Hegde, from day one, ever since he has been made a minister, he has been making statements which are hugely combustible. You see, this is all directed at the electorate in Karnataka. You see, the chief minister there is trying to stoke parochial sub-nationalist sentiments through raising the issues of flag, the state should have a flag, and that the language issue, Kannada language issue, and the culture of Kannada. And the BJP is trying to counter it by whipping up religious emotions for a broader polarization. Now, it's what you will see in the run-up to these elections will be a tussle between, parochial, sub-nationalist sentiment and religious sentiment. Similarly, in Rajasthan, elections are due. You would see more and more of these shrill voices as the elections get closer from BJP functionaries. And I wouldn't be surprised if they are not bridled. They are unbridled and they are allowed to do what they want to do.
It's been 24 hours, not a word from the BJP.
So we should be prepared for more of this, for an encore, so to speak, of such statements as we get closer to elections in these two states.
Then what explains what happens in Ghaziabad, what happened in Ghaziabad? Munna Kumar Sharma ji, kya aap koi shaadi agar karna chahta hai is desh mein, to kya aap hame BJP se permission leni padegi, Shiv Sena se permission leni padegi, Hindu Mahasabha se permission leni padegi, kyunki jo aapke neta hai BJP ke, jo president hai Ghaziabad ke, Musliman ladka aur Hindu ladki shaadi kar rahe hain, padhe likhe hain, apne man se shaadi kar rahe hain. You bring Ghaziabad to a standstill. क्यों? क्योंकि permission नहीं ली और love jihad है.
नहीं देखिए, love jihad का जो मामला है, वो बहुत बड़े स्तर पर चल रहा है.
किस बड़े स्तर पर? यहाँ पे तो लड़का जब कहते हैं ना मियाँ बीवी राजी तो क्या करेगा काजी? यहाँ पे तो काजी ने हंगामा खड़ा कर दिया.
यही तो हो रहा है कि सब लोग यही कर रहे हैं, लेकिन इतने बड़े पैमाने पर हो रहा है कि हिंदू लड़कियों का घर से निकलना मुश्किल हो रहा है, और ये पूरे देश में, केवल गाजियाबाद ही नहीं, ये पूरे देश में चल रहा है.
उस हिंदू लड़की ने तो आप लोगों के खिलाफ FIR कर दी, ये कह के कि आपने उसकी शादी जबरदस्ती रोकने की कोशिश की.
हो क्या रहा है कि उसको फंसाया जाता है, बरगलाया जाता है.
MBA है वो लड़की?
हाँ, वो अलग बात है, वो कुछ भी हो,
अनपढ़ लड़की नहीं
हो, डॉक्टर हो, इंजीनियर हो, कुछ भी हो, लेकिन इमोशनली ब्लैकमेल किया गया है. शिवाज इमोशनली ब्लैकमेल.
ये आपको कैसे पता? और बीजेपी के नेताओं को कैसे पता?
ऐसा ही हो रहा है, ऐसा ही हो रहा है. क्योंकि हम इसलिए हमें
और हिंदू महासभा को कैसे पता?
इसलिए पता है कि हमारे पास ऐसी लड़कियां अक्सर आती हैं जिनको मुस्लिम युवकों ने फुसला करके, बहका करके फंसाया, शादी किया, धर्म परिवर्तन कराया.
धर्म परिवर्तन
उन लड़कियों को बच्चे पैदा करने की मशीन बना दी.
अरे मुन्ना जी,
और उसके बाद कुछ वर्षों के बाद उसको घर से निकाल दिया.
मुन्ना जी, ये ख्याली पुलाव और ख्याली बिरयानी आप कई पका
हमारे
रहे?
हमारे पास अक्सर ऐसी लड़कियां आती रहती
मुन्ना जी. ये तो ख्याली बिरयानी है,
जिसका जबरदस्त शोषण हुआ है.
ये तो ख्याली बिरयानी है, क्योंकि धर्म परिवर्तन कहीं हुआ नहीं,
और गाजियाबाद
जबरदस्ती कहीं
गाजियाबाद नहीं है. तो
दोनों परिवार राजी है, लेकिन आप लोग बोल रहे हैं कि परिवार ने हमसे परमिशन नहीं ली, शादी नहीं हो सकती.
नहीं, ये
भारत देश में रहते हैं, ये डेमोक्रेसी है. अपनी मर्जी से शादी कर सकते हैं।
इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि आप एक षड्यंत्र के तहत किसी लड़की को फंसा के उसकी जिंदगी बर्बाद कर दीजिए। ये पूरा षड्यंत्र है और पूरी दुनिया को इस्लाम में बनाने का एक षड्यंत्र रचा जा रहा है।
अरे लेकिन लड़की के माँ बाप जो कि हिंदू हैं, उन्होंने आपके खिलाफ एफआईआर कर दी है।
हिंदुस्तान नहीं, पूरी दुनिया ये लव जिहाद के भय से भयभीत है।
नहीं, लव जिहाद से
इसीलिए हम इसीलिए अमेरिका जैसे देश को,
ये जो सैफरन ब्रिगेड है ना आपकी,
कई मुस्लिम देशों के लोगों को आने पर मनाही किया
गया। जो सैफरन ब्रिगेड है ना आपकी, सिर्फ उन्हीं को लव जिहाद से डर लगता है, बाकी इस देश में किसी को लव जिहाद का फंडा नहीं समझ आता।
सबको लग रहा है, सबको लग रहा है।
मोहम्मद खान के
आप केरल का उदाहरण लीजिए,
केरल में देखिए क्या हुआ है।
जिस व्यक्ति की बेटी का इस तरह से
और सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने क्या बोला है,
बनाया गया
और सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने क्या बोला है,
क्या वह व्यक्ति भी ये हिंदूवादी था? आप उसका एग्जांपल देखिए किस तरह से उसकी लड़की को फंसाया गया।
और सुलेमान मोहम्मद खान
उसको कांग्रेस में भेजने की योजना बनाई जा रही है।
सर ऐसी कोई योजना नहीं थी, आप प्लीज सुप्रीम कोर्ट जाके देखिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने क्या बोला है। आप प्लीज जाके बोल देखिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने क्या बोला है।
बड़ा शोषण हो रहा है,
मन धड़ंग कहानियां मत गड़ा करिए।
ये हिंदू महिलाओं
जो जनता है, आप लोग सब सोचते हैं जनता बेवकूफ है, जनता बेवकूफ नहीं है।
हिंदू महिलाओं की इज्जत क्या करेंगे, ये तो अपने घर की महिलाओं की इज्जत नहीं करते। अपनी पत्नी को केवल टेलीफोन से 3 बार तलाक तलाक कह के तलाक दे देते हैं, व्हाट्सएप से तलाक दे देते हैं, तो इनसे क्या उम्मीद किया जाए कि ये हिंदू लड़कियों को ले जाएंगे और उनकी
जी, आप बहुत सभ्य व्यक्ति है, हमारी बात हो रही थी स्टूडियो में फोर आने से पहले
जी,
लेकिन मैं आपको ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि और मैं बहुत आपसे विनम्रता से कहना चाहता हूँ कि हमारे देश में हमारे जो बीजेपी है उसके दो प्रमुख मुस्लिम नेता हैं, दोनों ने हिंदू लड़कियों से मोहब्बत करते थे, शादी की है। अगर वो कर सकते हैं तो और लोग क्यों नहीं कर सकते? अगर उनका प्यार पाक साफ हो सकता है तो दूसरों का क्यों नहीं हो सकता? तो देखिए मैं आपसे विनम्रता से एक बात कहना चाहता हूं कि जब भी ऐसा कोई विरोध करना हो तो उसको उस केस को जरा ध्यान से देख कर उसके बाद करना चाहिए। आप कीजिए, देखिए अगर कहीं ऐसा कुछ हो रहा है तो कीजिए, लेकिन सोच समझ के कीजिए। ऐसा मत कीजिए कि हर किसी को आप लपेट लें अपने कैंपेन में।
मुझे कहना है कि अगर ऐसा मामला नहीं होता तो केरल हाई कोर्ट को क्यों इसमें दखल देना
नहीं, वो अलग था।
और एनआईए जांच क्यों बैठानी पड़ी?
नहीं तो वो तो अलग हो गया, वो तो साफ हो गया, वो भी उसमें भी लड़की को छोड़ दिया उन्होंने।
ये एक वो मामला भी साफ हो गया है, वो मामला भी साफ हो गया है।
एनआईए ने क्या रिपोर्ट दिया?
वो देखना नहीं चाहते लेकिन मामला साफ हो गया। ओके, लेट्स गेट द कांग्रेस
कोर्ट में क्या रिपोर्ट दिया उसको देखिए।
मुन्ना जी,
एनआईए ने जो रिपोर्ट दिया है
मुन्ना जी,
वो बहुत ही खतरनाक है।
सुप्रीम कोर्ट को मानते हैं ना हम सब, मानते हैं सुप्रीम कोर्ट को इस देश में। जरा देखिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने क्या किया। सुलेमान मोहम्मद खान ओवर यू नो मणिशंकर अय्यर्स वन नीच कमेंट, द बीजेपी टुक यू टू द क्लीनर्स, यू आर सिटिंग ऑन अ गोल्ड माइन हियर, आई हैव अ लिस्ट ऑफ बीजेपी लीडर्स सेइंग क्रेजी थिंग्स एंड अगेन नॉट अ वर्ड फ्रॉम द कांग्रेस पार्टी, यू हैव हार्डली मेड एन इश्यू आउट ऑफ इट।
You know, Shreya, first of all, I'll congratulate you that you had your channel and you have run a program on this, showing the hateful and the bigotry and the prejudiced ideology of the BJP, how they are treating, you know, throwing it to the winds, the constitution, disrespect the constitution, degrade and denigrate the rule of law in the constitution, where the union ministers, where the union ministers of the union government are, you know, threatening to kill people, doctors who are treating patients if they are not in their program. You know, these union, BJP should understand that these union ministers, when they are in government, they are public servants. They are not kings. It's a democracy. It's not, you know, monarchy that they will, everyone will come with a red carpet for them. They were absent, whatever reason. You cannot threaten doctors that we will pump bullets in you. Secondly, the other union minister, Mr. Hegde, he has said that, we'll, you know, we have a plan to change the constitution, or the people who talk about secularism, they don't know their parental lineage or whatever he has said. But you know, this shows the mindset, the character and the nature of the BJP and the RSS who are ruling the country. One MLA from Rajasthan says we'll kill people who will try to smuggle cows or slaughter cows, whatever. They have no respect for the law. Congress party has raised this issue. You know, from Indian National Congress platform, we have done a press conference and we have been,
where
today only, Shreya, we have done a PC and we, you know, we have raised this issue
completely
on
missing
every
from
platform.
The radar.
You know, it's your responsibility. No. Gaurav Gogoi, our Member of Parliament, and Khushbu Sundar, our spokesperson, both of them have done a press conference in the evening. And state units have also, you know, raised this issue. And we have been raising this issue for past 3.5 years.
Ajaz,
it's not about, you know, it's also your responsibility. And therefore, at the outset, I have congratulated you that you have raised this issue.
Ajaz Ilmi,
you know,
can I get
one more thing, Shreya? One more thing.
Can I get in
Ajaz one more
Ilmi
thing,
very quickly?
Shreya, one more thing.
Okay.
May I, one more thing.
Go ahead.
Shreya, one.
Go ahead.
One more thing.
Go ahead.
The only issue is one comment by Mani Shankar Iyer. Mm-hmm. We suspended him within an hour. Mm-hmm. But Prime Minister is, you know, sitting quiet. Mm-hmm. Union ministers are, you know, disrespecting, denigrating and degrading the constitution. Mm-hmm. And Prime Minister is, it's a tacit support of the government with these ministers. What can we say? People are getting killed.
Ajaz Ilmi, the problem
communal
is with the BJP's
DNA, minds.
Says the Congress. The problem is with the BJP's DNA. Your DNA is intolerant. We suspended a Mani Shankar Iyer over his niche comment. Why can't you do the same with these two union ministers?
As let me just qualify this allegation that the DNA is warped or DNA is something wrong with the DNA. There is nothing wrong with the DNA of any political party. Individuals can behave as motor mouths and give statements which are definitely not in sync with the constitution and rule of the law. That can suggest an individual,
you know,
alliteration or alteration
individual.
Of a DNA.
Secondly,
Union
Minister's
secondly,
statement
Suleiman,
is
don't
a statement of
me.
The
Suleiman,
government.
Don't filibuster me, Suleiman. Let's be polite. Yes, sir, don't show
please.
Intolerance right now.
You know, you have to
let
clarify.
Suleiman, let me speak, Suleiman. Suleiman.
I'll not be polite.
Your entire Congress party does not have the DNA of Mani Shankar Iyer. Your entire Congress party does not have the DNA of Mr. Mani Shankar Iyer. Congress party is different. Mani Shankar Iyer is different.
Therefore,
I'm qualifying it. Your allegation
it's
that the entire DNA
statement.
Of the BJP is warped.
A statement
is
of a union government
is
a statement
the DNA
of a
government. Of the Congress
and
party
is
different
mute.
From the DNA of
on this.
Mr. Mani Shankar
Iyer. Well spoken, the Prime Minister
Mani Shankar Iyer's mindset
this.
Is not
you
that
have to reply to this.
Of the entire Congress party.
You should
have
suspended
the entire
we have suspended Mani Shankar Iyer. You should suspend these ministers from your cabinet. The Prime Minister should suspend these ministers from the cabinet.
I can outspeak you. During my time, I will speak. If you filibuster me, I will continue speaking. Suleiman.
Just
as a youngster,
by
you have to learn. This is not a Mufassil court.
You cannot
where you can argue. It's a structured debate on a national
statement.
Media channel.
A statement of the union government is a statement of the government.
Time and I will speak. You can
what
continue
action
to
you have taken?
Me.
Just tell
it doesn't
me. What
wash.
Action you
it
have
doesn't
taken?
Help you. It
Shreya,
shows your own
just
DNA.
What action
it
they
shows
have
the same DNA. You're displaying
what action
intolerant
you have
DNA,
taken?
Which Mani Shankar Iyer
my
displays.
Question
do
to
not
you
okay,
is,
gentlemen.
What action you have taken?
Okay, gentlemen. Let's bring in some decency and sense back into this debate. Gentlemen,
Shreya, you gave me time, I'm speaking to you.
Yes, gentlemen, let's get some decency and sense back into this debate. Quick closing comments. Ajaz Ilmi, you were trying to make a point. Why has the Prime Minister not reacted or pulled up these erring ministers publicly? It's the least he could have done.
Yes, this is a question.
The Prime Minister is aware of what has been said and the party takes his own call and there's a mechanism that will be addressed. But obviously, if the statements are definitely not in sync with the party's what the party's ideology is, and obviously there's no question of changing the constitution wholesale as anybody is suggesting. And secondly, marriage between two consenting adults is legal. It has sanctions. It has constitutional protection, and nobody can do anything about it. Okay, people can keep on speaking about this, but two individuals who are consenting
that's
adults have
why
a free
don't
right
you send that message
under
down
to
your leaders in Ghaziabad? Your leaders in Ghaziabad don't seem to understand that basic logic. Ajaz, very quickly, Mohammad Khan, and very quickly, Mohammad Khan, 30 seconds closing comments.
You know, just two things. Yeah, Shreya, just two things. Suspension from the primary membership of a party is the prerogative of the party. But removal from the ministry is a prerogative of the Prime Minister. When the union ministers are talking like this, the Prime Minister can remove them from the ministry. Not even a single notice, show cause notice has been given. Second, about the Ghaziabad incident and what that person from that Hindu Mahasabha was saying, I want to say that Supreme Court has, you know, made things very clear about that Hadia case.
Correct.
And it is a complete propaganda of the BJP, RSS and their affiliates to just, you know, degrade Muslims and, you know, just produce a fake propaganda about this Love Jihad. And now that Land Jihad has also started in Meerut. So they have to reply to that.
Munna ji? जी बोलिए, 30 सेकंड है आपके।
देखिए, मैं इनसे, ये जो कांग्रेस के सज्जन हैं, इनसे पूछना चाहता हूँ कि ये एक MLA ने कह दिया कि जो गायों की हत्या करेगा उसकी हत्या हो जाएगी, उसका परिणाम यही होगा, उस पर ये प्रश्न चिन्ह लगा रहे हैं। मैं इनसे पूछना चाहता हूँ कि इनका एक नेता इमरान मसूद ने कहा कि नरेंद्र मोदी को काट दूंगा, उस पर इन्होंने कांग्रेस ने क्या एक्शन लिया? कांग्रेस का एक सीनियर लीडर है वो उत्तर प्रदेश का, आपने क्या एक्शन उस पर लिया?
उनका प्रमोशन हो गया,
प्रधानमंत्री को कह रहा है कि उसको हम काट के फेंक देंगे और उस पर इन्होंने कोई एक्शन नहीं लिया। और एक व्यक्ति कह रहा है कि गायों की हत्या जो करेगा उसका यही हाल होगा, उसका ये विरोध कर रहे हैं कि बीजेपी ने उसको पार्टी से निकाला क्यों नहीं, इनसे पूछ के बीजेपी उसको निकालेगा, क्या उसने गलत कहा? जो गायों की हत्या करेगा उसका परिणाम तो यही
होगा,
उसका परिणाम तो यही हो
रहा है। गलत किया तो यानी आप भी गलत करेंगे,
उसका परिणाम तो मिल ही रहा है उसको, आप लोग सब देख रहे हैं, इसमें नई सी कौन सी बात है? जो गौ माता की हत्या करेगा उसका क्या परिणाम होगा? उसको तो सजा यही मिलेगी।
लास्ट कमेंट टू यू, आर यू सरप्राइज्ड दैट वी आर सो, एक मिनट, लास्ट कमेंट टू विनोद शर्मा, आर यू सरप्राइज्ड दैट देयर हैज बीन एब्सोल्युटली नो रिएक्शन फ्रॉम द प्राइम मिनिस्टर और एनी टॉप लीडर फ्रॉम द बीजेपी? दे शुड बी एंबैरस्ड,
आई एक्सपेक्ट अ क्लेरिफिकेशन फ्रॉम एन ऑथराइज्ड फंक्शनरी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द बीजेपी ऑन व्हाट मिस्टर अनंत हेगडे हैज सेड। A minister is a creature of the constitution. And he is suggesting that they are going to alter the constitution. I would like to remind through you, Mr. Hegde, a statement Mr. L.K. Advani made, I think in the 11th or 12th house, that, you know, what he said, the genesis of the Kashmir dispute lies in the fact that India negated Jinnah's two-nation theory by declaring itself as a non-denominational secular state. Now, when you are making comment on the constitution and the secular character of the constitution, you are compromising national interests gravely in areas of dispute like Jammu and Kashmir. You must tell your ministers to be more responsible. They are creatures of the constitution. They are not the masters of the constitution. Constitution has been altered many times before, but the Supreme Court has said that you cannot alter the basic structure of the constitution. This basic education, a minister of the union must have when he takes an oath under the constitution, and it's very serious on the part of
a
that
little
man.
Bit
it's
of
a serious lapse on his part to have made this statement.
A little bit of disciplining will go a long way, Jaz Ilmi, for your party. Thank you very much, all of you, for joining us on the debate. Munna Sharma, thank you very much. Vinod Sharma ji, thank you very much for being here. Jaz Ilmi, spokesperson of the BJP, and Suleiman Muhammad Khan. On the other side of the story, the big story that we've been tracking through the day today, the big farce that the Jadhav meeting was. Exclusive details coming up. Do stay with us. Welcome back. Heckled, humiliated, disrobed. This was not humanity. This was humiliation. Here are the details that are now emerging from the meeting between Kulbushan Jadhav and his wife and mother that happened yesterday in Pakistan. Sources are telling Network 18 that Jadhav's mother expressed grave disappointment, saying that her son looked different and behaved differently while she spoke to him through a glass window. Remember, Pakistan didn't have the decency to allow mother and son to meet or to hug each other. Jadhav's mother also said that they were not informed by Pakistan that a separate set of clothes were kept for them to change before they met Kulbushan Jadhav. So what happens is that both the ladies are asked to change their clothes and remove their shoes. Interestingly, these shoes were such a big security threat for Pakistan that they refused to give them back. Also a security threat for Pakistan was Kulbushan Jadhav's wife's Mangal Sutra, which they took away before the meeting got underway. Sources are also saying that the sham medical report on Jadhav that was released by Pakistan is nothing but a political move. Sources are saying that the doctor who examined Jadhav was misled. He says he didn't know that he was examining Jadhav, and that the medical report that was flaunted to the Pakistani media was against the doctor's wishes, against medical ethics. The MEA, the Ministry of External Affairs, is also saying that Jadhav has been tortured in custody.
we note with regret that the Pakistani side conducted this meeting in a manner which violated the letter and spirit of our understandings. The Pakistani press was allowed on multiple occasions to approach family members closely, harass and hector them, and hurt false and motivated accusations about Shri Jadhav. This was despite a clear agreement that the media would not be allowed close access. Under the pretext of security precautions, the cultural and religious sensibilities of family members were disregarded. This included removal of Mangal Sutra, bangles and bindi, as well as a change in attire that was not warranted by security. The mother of Shri Jadhav was prevented from talking in their mother tongue, although this was clearly the natural medium of communication. She was repeatedly interrupted while doing so and eventually prevented from proceeding further in this regard. Deputy High Commissioner was initially separated from family members who were taken to the meeting without informing him. The meeting was started without his presence and he could join only after pressing the matter with concerned officials. For some inexplicable reason, despite her repeated requests, the shoes of the wife of Shri Jadhav were not returned to her after the meeting. We would caution against any mischievous intent in this regard. The overall atmosphere of the meeting was intimidating insofar as family members were concerned.
Major General Rajesh Arya is a defense expert. He is joining us here. We'll also be getting in a Pakistani voice. General Arya, simple question. If Pakistan had this in mind, if this is the sort of meeting that they had in mind, why did they say yes? They should have simply said no for a 23rd time. This was humiliating for the family that has not seen their son or their husband in 22 months. This is not what they deserved. This is not what any decent nation would do.
Good evening, Shreya. You are absolutely right. I would say maybe not completely right, less right. You know, we need to understand the Pakistan actions of past 5 days, starting on 22nd when they had the medical examination of Jadhav done, till yesterday. What Pakistan did in these couple of days is a total international diplomatic farce. It was purely done on one of the requests from the Indian side to let the family meet Kulbhushan Jadhav. They had denied the consular access. They had always alleged he is a terrorist, and as per their military law, the terrorists are not supposed to be granted any access. So what they have done under international pressure and the Indian pressure, a total diplomatic farce exercise to try and convince the international community that they were dealing with this case with a total humanitarian approach. Unfortunately for Pakistan, that this entire humanitarian farce exploded in their face on the return of the family to back to India yesterday.
Taimur Shamil, Pakistan should have just said no.
Mr. Shamil, that was requested by the family of Kulbhushan Yadav and they wanted to meet him. Hmm. And Pakistan has nothing to hide. Pakistan is open to the meeting. Huh. And also to the world as well, that Kulbhushan Yadav is in, you know, robust health in Pakistan's custody. They can meet them, and this was on purely humanitarian grounds.
Because Pakistan has nothing to hide, and also, if Pakistan had nothing to hide, Taimur Shamil, let me ask you a question here. If Pakistan had nothing to hide, why have that glass wall between a mother and a son? Why not let them hug or touch? It's what any decent country would do. It's what any decent person would do. Forget country, it's what any decent person would do. What is the security threat in wearing shoes?
If you allow me to complete my point, the thing is that this is a Kulbhushan Yadav, according to the Pakistani authorities, is a terrorist. So, we are not talking about decency, because this is the person who was instigating the insurgency and terrorism in Pakistan. Huh. Right? So, he is not layman, not a common man, not a common Indian who is in Pakistan and we are letting him meet his family. Hmm. He is a terrorist.
So?
Family. Huh. And you need to have some precautions and security measures as well.
So, what were the Pakistanis like expecting?
Pakistan is open because...
His 80-year-old mother was a human bomb. She would come and hug him and blow off the center where they were meeting. Is that what Pakistan was expecting?
But I think that's just emotional rhetoric. The thing is,
how is it emotional rhetoric?
Anything to hide.
It's just plain stupidity on the side of Pakistan. It was plain stupidity, sir.
Let me complete my point.
how is a Mangal Sutra, sir, how is a Mangal Sutra a security threat? Sir, how is a Mangal Sutra a security threat? Please tell me, how are shoes a security threat? How are the clothes you are wearing a security threat, sir?
I think this gesture itself from Pakistan is enough. Had Pakistan something to hide, Pakistan would have taken Kulbushan Yadav to some jail or, you know, some Adiyala jail or somewhere else.
You tried him in a banana court, for heaven's sake. You tried him in a banana court without evidence. He didn't have a lawyer to represent him. What are you saying, sir? Major General Arya, would you want to respond to what Taimur Shah is saying?
Shreya, my submission to your guest from Pakistan is,
he was also tried before,
if he is ready to listen,
civil magistrate and then taken to the military court. Please, you know, keep your records straight.
No, sir, we don't have any records. We don't have any records. Because Pakistan's military operates in a strange way, sir. We don't have records. How do you have records of a banana court?
Mr. Taimur, neither you have an access to records nor I have an access to records. Mr. Taimur, just listen to me. Neither you have an access to official records, neither I have an access to records. We are all going by the news in the media. Today, just 2 hours back, the Indian MEA spokesperson has gone on record and list out all the misconduct conducted by the Pakistan government. And he has gone on record to say that this meeting would have been gone into great details on agreed terms.
Jadhav has been tortured in custody, sir.
What was so
Kulbushan? Kulbushan Jadhav has been tortured in custody, sir.
As per there Indian records,
if you look at the person, does he look tortured?
Yes, he does.
He was in pretty much robust health and pretty
yes,
much.
Yes, he does, sir. His mother came out to say that he doesn't look his normal self. No, he wasn't. His mother has come out to say he wasn't his normal self. There were enough visible signs of torture on his body. That's what the mother is saying, sir. The doctor who has examined him has told Network 18 that there are visible signs of torture on his body.
Either we can keep on debating about the anti-Pakistan, anti-India rhetoric, or we can talk about something substantial, and that is that now we have to move forward.
How do you talk about anything talk substantial about, with Pakistan, a country that doesn't even let a mother and son meet? This was supposed to be a humanitarian gesture. You know, Shamil, can I just quickly ask you a question?
One more thing.
This was supposed to be a humanitarian gesture on Pakistan's part. Am I correct? They were showing their Darya Dili. Is this how Pakistan shows its Darya Dili?
This is not the last time that his family is meeting Kulbushan Yadav.
I hope so.
There would be a meet if his family wants to meet him in the future, they might meet him, because as yet, Pakistan is obviously not going to, you know, execute Kulbushan Yadav. There are chances for peace and stability. If India reciprocates, perhaps we can look forward to
peace and stability sounds very good, only if your soldiers didn't cross across the LOC and kill four of our soldiers. Because of it, we had to cross your border and kill four of your soldiers.
If you want to talk about that cross-border terrorism, then Kulbushan Yadav
Taimur Shamil, I'm afraid I've run out of time, but I appreciate your time here on Network 18. Thank you very much. Major General Alia, thank you very much for joining us here. Thank you very much indeed. With that, I'm slipping into a quick break on the show. Coming up next, we are showing you how doctors in Uttar Pradesh party, belly dancers, and what are ambulances being used for? Well, there you'll see them in just a bit. They are being used to carry the booze. Can someone explain this picture to us? That's coming up in just a bit. Do stay with us. Hello everyone, welcome back. Now, doctors work very hard, they have every right to party. So, if doctors in Meerut in Uttar Pradesh decide to call belly dancers for their party, which by the way is being held in a government hospital, that's perfectly fine. But when they use ambulances meant for patients to carry booze, they're crossing the line. Take a look.
Russian belly dancers performing at an event in Meerut. What's so special, one would argue? It is actually when the location happens to be a hospital. Yes, welcome to a doctor's grand party inside a hospital in Meerut. Patients can wait, but the party just cannot. And here's the shocking part. Ambulances meant for patients were used to ferry cartons of liquor. While doctors enjoyed an ambulance bar and these exotic dancers, patients were left to fend for themselves. Following the uproar over the misuse of ambulances, the principal of the medical college has ordered a probe into the incident.
एम्बुलेंस में भर के इन्होंने शराब वगैरह ढोई है तो इसमें मेरे पास भी फ़ोन आया था मैंने ये कहा था कि चिकित्सा शिक्षा विभाग से ये एक बार संपर्क कर लें तो शायद डायरेक्टर जनरल से इनकी बात हुई थी जो मेडिकल एजुकेशन के हैं जांच के उन्होंने आदेश दे दिए हैं कि किन परिस्थितियों में ऐसा हुआ है किसकी परमिशन से हुआ है
As patients across the nation are denied ambulances. For doctors in Meerut, ambulance is nothing but a vehicle to carry booze.
This in a state where it's perfectly normal for oxygen to run out and 30 children to choke to their death. Perfectly normal to have ambulances carry booze as well then. What do you say to a story like that? Write to me. My Twitter handle is at Shreya Dhoundial. It's a wrap with that. Arundhati Mukherjee joining you with all the day's top stories. Do stay on with us.